Hey guys, how's it going? This is the Power Gunner, and welcome to my review of Star Wars: The Force Awakens. This is the first time I have reviewed a movie because I really felt like doing a review of this movie. So, I'm sure you know, but if you don't know, this movie is Star Wars Episode 7. And I will say right now that if you are a big Star Wars fan, I don't think you should watch this review, because I think you should go to the movie without knowing much about it. And I'm not going to spoil the movie. Like, I'll talk about spoilers in this, but there will be warning before the part that I do. Like, I won't really spoil the movie, but I just know, because I'm a huge Star Wars fan, that things I'm talking about, I wouldn't even want to hear, like, even though they aren't really spoilers.
Hey, Smidge. It's my cat. Yeah, she's in, like, 10% of my videos, so I don't need to say it every time, really. But anyway, so yeah, if you're a big fan of Star Wars, well, you've probably seen the movie already. But if not, I'd say watch my review after you see it. But if you're not, like, a huge fan of Star Wars, then yeah, this is what I think. First, without spoilers. I'll have fair warning before I talk spoilers. So, I have seen this movie twice now. And, well, the first time was on opening night. Second time was on Saturday. I don't know when I upload this video, but it'll probably be the last Saturday before when I upload this. Unless I upload it really late for some strange reason. So the first thing that I am going to say with this movie is this is the fourth real Star Wars movie. This is a real Star Wars movie. It feels like Star Wars. And the prequels, you know, they didn't. They were terrible movies. But this movie, I'm just going to say, it's fantastic. I loved this movie. It's just a very fun movie, a very fast-paced movie. Also a very very emotional movie in many ways. So let's talk about why this movie is so good. First off, it feels like Star Wars. The use of practical special effects in this movie makes it feel a lot like it. And this movie has really good special effects. Both the practical stuff and the CG stuff just look really good. Sometimes when you see the CG stuff, it really looks CG, just because you're used to seeing mostly practical stuff in the movie, so sometimes it sort of sticks out when you see it, but I think it looked good enough for the movie, definitely. And then, let's see here. One thing that this movie does that some people might not like is it doesn't explain certain things. And there's some things I think it should have maybe explained, but I like that it doesn't explain everything, because when you do just explain everything in the movie, that's when you get movies like the prequels, who give us answers to things that we probably would have rather had kept a mystery, and it turns out that the answers to things weren't as cool as what we thought they would be, or, you know, something like that. And it's always nice to have mystery and have something that you don't know and you can fill in the gap with what's in your mind. Obviously, some things are going to be explained in the next two movies in the sequel trilogy. But yeah, so let's talk about why this movie is so good. The main reason is the characters. This movie has great characters. They're really, really well written, and they're acted really well. I'm going to talk about some of the characters. I won't talk about what happens to them, really. I'll mention some things of who the characters are based on what you see in the trailers and what they talked about before they showed the movie. So I'm not really spoiling anything in my mind with that. If you're that concerned about knowing anything about the movie, then don't watch this, like I said previously. So, first, I'll just talk about the old characters first, because why not? So, the main old character in this movie is Han Solo. And one thing that I kind of worried about is that it wouldn't be Han Solo, but it would just be Harrison Ford. But Harrison Ford is Han Solo in this movie. He's not just Harrison Ford in this movie. Like, it is Han Solo. And he's not only playing Han Solo, he's playing Han Solo that's like aged 30 plus years past when we last saw him. And it's just done really well. And with all of the old characters that are in this movie, none of them are in this movie just for the purpose of like, oh, cool, look, it's this character. Like, all of them serve a purpose in this story, and mostly Han. There's also Chewie and Leia, C-3PO. There's a few others. I don't want to talk about everything in the movie. Well, one thing that I heard Mark Hamill say when this movie wasn't out yet is that he technically doesn't know if he's even like able to say if he's in the movie, because I won't spoil why. There's tons of theories people have on why he wasn't in the trailers. I know why he wasn't in the trailers. It's pretty obvious once you see the movie. But anyways, I won't talk about Luke in the movie yet. So I'll save that for the spoiler talk part. So old characters are done really well. The new characters are what's really, like, really exciting in many ways. So first there's Finn, who is a stormtrooper who decides that he doesn't want to be a stormtrooper because they're evil. And everything with that character, how they set him up and how his character just acts, he doesn't really act the way that you might expect from the trailers. And I won't spoil his character, but I really like Finn. He's just a very new kind of character in Star Wars. Like, no other characters are really like him, I'd say. Then there is Poe. He is an X-Wing pilot in the Resistance. I really like this guy, too. He's just funny and, like, cheerful and... yeah. I don't want to say much more about him. BB-8 was a character that people worried might be sort of like the new Jar Jar or something, like this cutesy droid that's just like, no. But BB-8 is awesome. He's just awesome. He's cute. Well, I mean, he or she doesn't matter. It's a droid. It doesn't have a gender. But yeah, he's both cute. He's so funny. And that's one thing with this movie that I wasn't expecting going in, is this movie is really, really funny. There's, like, tons of great jokes and humor in it. It's not, like, Jar Jar or anything. It's, like, real humor that's actually funny. And then for other new characters, there's Rey, who is a scavenger on a planet, and she basically lives on her own. I don't want to say anything else about her character. I was worried about her character because this is really like the first movie that Daisy Ridley, the actor, that she's been in. So I was worried that she wouldn't be good at acting, but she's fantastic. Her character is great. I don't want to say anything more. And then Kylo Ren, which I think is probably the most interesting character in this movie. He's a great villain. Probably not in the way that you would expect him to be. Or I'd say more than being a great villain, he is a great character. He has flaws, and he has things going on with him that I don't want to spoil it, but he is very well acted, and he's a very complex character. And he's not just like Darth Vader 2.0. He's very different from Darth Vader, and you'll see why in the movie. I really like how they did his character. I'd even say that with Kylo Ren in this one movie versus Darth Vader in his one first movie that he was in, I would say that Kylo Ren is a better character than Darth Vader, judging by their first movie that they're in. because, like, obviously Vader gets way more, like, better in Empire Strikes Back. But, yeah, so, anyways, I'm sort of maybe running out of time with the gameplay that I recorded here, so I'm gonna move a little bit faster. The soundtrack for this movie is great. It's John Williams, Star Wars, sounds awesome. The action in this movie is great. The way that they do things, and like none of the action or special effects are there to be cool. They're all there to serve a purpose in the story, and that's what feels like Star Wars to me, and I really like that. Okay, now there's only one major thing for me to talk about in the non-spoiler part, and it's the issues that I have with this movie, which is really not that many, but I guess really this is kind of basically the only issue that I have with it is there are certain things in this movie that feel very similar to Star Wars A New Hope. Some plot points are just extremely similar. Not all of them. Like, this movie isn't just a copy or a clone of it, but there's certain parts that are like, that's been done before, that's very similar. So I think the movie could have done with some less of that. I think it's not the worst thing ever that they did that much of it, because in some ways I sort of feel like when bringing in these new movies, it's nice to have it feel like the old ones, like a lot. I think maybe they went too far in some places with trying to make it feel like the old ones, but it's not that big of a problem with the movie. And the biggest source of it feeling like a New Hope is something called Starkiller Base, which I'm not going to spoil what it is, except for it is a super weapon that is extremely similar to the Death Star. And I felt like the Death Star, when they did the second Death Star in Return of the Jedi, I thought that was a little, sort of like maybe they should have done something new. So then when they do basically a third Death Star in this movie, I was kind of like, okay, maybe not having another Death Star would be nice. I hope they don't have a fourth one now. But other than that, Starkiller Base itself is different from a Death Star, and it's special. I'm not going to say why. I think that would be a spoiler. But it's very cool. I think it's cooler than any of the Death Stars. It just feels like the same thing again, sort of. But that's fine, because it's not really too major of a thing in the movie that has too much screen time of it being so similar to past movies. But anyways, that's all I'm going to say for the non-spoiler part. I'm going to talk some spoilers now, so leave if you haven't seen the movie yet. Yeah, because this movie has some big spoiler-type things you wouldn't want to know going in. But yes, I love this movie. I'd say it's my third favorite Star Wars movie. I like it more than Return of the Jedi. I don't like it more than A New Hope or The Empire Strikes Back. Which, the Empire Strikes Back is my favorite Star Wars movie. Or favorite any movie ever. So yeah, now I will talk about spoilers. Please leave now. I'll give you like 5 seconds to leave. And then I am going to say the most spoilery possible thing in this, just to motivate you to leave right now, okay? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Han Solo dies. Okay, there we go. So, I'm sure everyone's gone if they truly cared about the movie not being spoiled. So, I'm not going to talk about Han Solo's death as the first spoiler thing, because I'd rather do it in, like, chronological order, sort of. So, okay. I'm just going through the movie in my head. I've seen it twice, so I have a pretty good feel for the movie and stuff. So, first is the opening crawl text. I think it is a real... Okay, I had to start a new voice recording. I guess it ended, but yeah, it's a really good crawl text. Like, it just gets to the point and tells you what this movie is about and stuff. And it's like, Luke Skywalker has vanished. I just love that first line. It just sets the tone for the movie and stuff. Yeah, it was great, I think. Then you see Poe on Jakku and Kylo Ren comes. Okay, I really like what they did with what the Force can do in this movie, because the prequels didn't show you anything new that the Force can do. This shows some, like, new things that make sense based on old things we've seen with the Force. Like, you can read minds, and what Kylo Ren does, well, he reads people's minds, and then also he can just, like, stop people and lock them in, like, lock them so they can't move, basically. And you see in the start of the movie, he just freezes a laser in midair, and that was just awesome. And then once he, like, leaves, it just finishes shooting. That was really cool. Let's see. So Finn is awesome. He's just he just feels so, like, happy to be in a Star Wars movie. The actor as he plays him and stuff, and I love how Finn gets his name and how he meets Poe and stuff. I thought that was really cool. And then one thing that I really like, this is kind of jumping ahead a bit, but with BB-8, when Finn gives him the thumbs up and then BB-8, like, flips out the lighter like a thumbs up, that was just so funny, so awesome. Yeah, there's some great humor, like the trash compactor reference. One thing that I will say with this movie, I feel like certain characters didn't necessarily get as much time in the movie as maybe they should have. Now, Captain Phasma, judging just based on the movie, she's in the movie very little. But I feel like she didn't really need a bigger role in the movie. Like, that's the thing, like, because of all the toys of her and stuff, they make you think she's in it more, but she's really not. I think she played a fine role, though, as being Finn's boss, basically. I think she worked in that. It would be nice if she's in the next one. I don't know if she died or not. I feel like she probably didn't. But if they actually put her in a trash compactor, then when Starkiller Base blew up, then, well, she's dead. Anyways, let's step back a bit. So, Rey is awesome. She's actually basically the main character in this movie. I mean, it's kind of both her and Finn, but more her than Finn. And she's the real one who can use the Force, and she's really strong in the Force. I just love the scene where she first uses the Force when there's Kylo Ren. I feel like there's so many things to talk about with this movie, so I'm going to move a bit faster and not mention everything, or just talk faster. So it was really cool when the Falcon first came into the movie, and it's like that ship's junk, and then the one they're trying to get to blows up. I was like, okay, junk ship it is. Pans over, it's the Falcon. That was awesome. And then they leave. I love how they meet Han and Chewie. Han and Chewie just felt like they'd be doing Han and Chewie things with the smuggler stuff. That was really cool. Leia was cool. Maz Kanata was a very cool character. And I like that they had monsters with the... whatchamacallit? What are they called? I have the soundtrack on my phone. I know it says it in one of the things. The Wrath-tars. I didn't even have to look at it. Yeah, the Wrath-tar things, they look pretty CG. Maybe they couldn't have looked as CG, but I like that they had monsters in a Star Wars movie. That's something that I've always liked. I'm going to need to get more gameplay here because this video is ending up really long. I think I'm going to have to stop the recording here. Maybe. Let's see if it keeps on going. Let's see. Sorry, this is ending up to be really long, but if you want me to... Okay, it's still going. If you want me to talk about spoilers, though, this is good for you. Okay, so... blah, 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 blah. Kind of jumping ahead here with Starkiller Base. I feel like, first off, like, maybe they shouldn't have had it, but Also, maybe they shouldn't have blown it up in this movie. Like, maybe they should have waited till the next one or the one after that, even. Yeah. I just wasn't sure if they should have blown it up already. And then, one thing that didn't make sense to me at first was the map to Luke, and it still kind of doesn't, but it was... I mean, it's not that bad, I don't think. So let's talk about Kylo Ren. He's the son of Han Solo and Leia, which I thought was really good, and he was trained by Luke, but then he turned on Luke, and that's what made Luke run away, basically, and feel very guilty for what happened. So why Kylo Ren is so awesome is because he's trying to be like Darth Vader, but he basically knows that he can't live up to being as good as his grandfather was. Well, as good of a bad guy as he was. And it's really cool because, like, in sort of real life with the Star Wars fandom, like, most people... I mean, it would be hard for this character to live up to being as cool as Darth Vader was. Now, I think he's a better character in his first movie. I think he's probably going to be really awesome in the next one. Based on what happened in this, he'll have that scar on his face from the lightsaber fight. This lightsaber fight was awesome. It just... It wasn't any of that stupid dancing type looking stuff that was all flashy and all that. Like, this was a real fight, and that's what I felt for the lightsaber fight. I'm kind of jumping around with this now, but... Yeah, I really like how Kylo Ren just slashes the stuff up with his lightsaber when he gets mad, and how he basically, the main difference with him and Vader is he is not sure of himself, and he cannot control himself. He just goes crazy with his anger when, like, Vader would choke some people, but he was still, like, calm. Kylo Ren is not that. So yeah, he's very cool. I like his lightsaber. It's a nice design. I think Rey destroyed his lightsaber, I'm pretty sure, in the fight at the end. Like, 99% sure. So maybe he'll come back with a different one. Maybe he'll, like, remake his... I don't know. Like, I think in the next movie he'll probably come back with one that's maybe more stable, because it felt like with this lightsaber that he made, like, he doesn't exactly know how to make a lightsaber, and that's why it was all, like, unstable and weird. I think it looked really cool, sort of like lightning looking, because it wasn't put together all right in a way. So let's see. I liked Han and Chewie's jokes with Chewie's bow weapon. I think it's called the bowcaster. That was cool. And then Leia was great. I love how C-3PO just comes into the movie. He's like, "Oh, hello, Han Solo. You probably don't recognize me because of the red arm." And the look on Han's face when he sees C-3PO, he's like, "Oh my gosh, not you again." It's awesome. I also love how they don't explain why he has a red arm or certain things like that. It's like, 'cause they really don't need to. The things that I think they could have explained more is how the Resistance and the First Order, like, what their goals are, sort of how they came about, sort of, from the Rebels and the Empire. That's something that didn't really make sense in the movie. That could have been explained a little better. Yeah, there's some great stuff there. Then... I guess the big moment is when Han gets killed by his son. That was such a powerful scene, such a tense scene. I thought that is the perfect way to kill Han Solo, because it serves the story and the character of his son, Ben Solo, which we learn his real name is. Yeah, then there's the lightsaber fight. I talked about that. I talked about blowing up Starkiller Base. And then there's basically just the very end of the movie where Rey goes and she goes to Luke. She finds Luke. And the reason why Luke isn't in the trailers is because he's only in, like, half a minute of the movie or less. I'm fine with that. I think that how they showed Luke was really cool. I think Luke looks very cool. And he doesn't just look like old Mark Hamill with a beard. He looks like old Mark Hamill with a beard, but also just the way that his hair moves in the wind and how his eyes just looked at things. He just looks like he's Luke and not just, you know, old Mark Hamill with a beard. I like that. And then I thought that was a great place to end the movie on a cliffhanger there while the characters were literally standing on a cliff. I think it's cool. They can show Luke in the next one. I mean, I'd assume he's going to train Rey. I don't see why he wouldn't. I feel like Rey is probably his daughter. Although, I don't know. That's just what I think. So, yeah, this has gone on for longer than I thought it would, just because I like talking about Star Wars. So, yeah, guys, thank you for watching my review of Star Wars and the spoiler part. Obviously, if you're here, I hope you saw the movie and aren't just spoiling the movie for yourself. I don't know why anyone would want to do that, but... yeah, I now have to go capture more gameplay because I talked longer than I thought I would. So, yeah, thanks for watching. Check out Fog/Arcane Shadows channel. He supports me on Patreon. So yeah, check out his channel. He makes some videos too. and yeah, guys, thanks for watching. And again, sorry, I haven't made a video in a while. I'm on Christmas break now, so I could probably make some more, and I will probably get my computer next month. How awesome is that?